Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to insert video in iSpring courses. To complement your PowerPoint slides with narration video, open up the narration editor. To insert pre-recorded video files, click the video button and select one or more files. You can insert AVI, WMV, MPG, MP4, and MKV formats. Here in this window, you can insert the videos at the current cursor position or at the beginning of the selected slide, and you can also choose to automatically adjust each slide duration to the length of each video clip. Once the videos are inserted, you can select them on the timeline and open them with the iSpring Video Editor. Here you can trim out any parts you don't need, plus perform noise removal and volume adjustment. When you're done, click Save and Close in both windows to return to PowerPoint. Just as a reminder, the classic way to insert video in PowerPoint is to go to the Insert tab and select Video, then just put it right on the slide. But the problem here is that it takes up space on the slide, and you can't get the video to play smoothly across all slides. Therefore, it's highly recommended to use iSpring. Now go to Publish. And here you can select the right player to show your narration video. The universal player shows it in an upper corner, and the video lecture player shows it side by side with your PowerPoint slides, and the viewer can even click and drag to adjust the ratio. Another thing you can do in the publish window is adjust the video compression. If you have a lot of video, you may want to drag this slider down a bit. Make sure you check out how it looks after publishing, and don't be afraid to publish high-quality video if you know your audience has high-speed internet. Thanks for watching. Now you know how to insert video in iSpring courses. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.